हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू निधिज क्रिएटिव जोन। टुडेज रेसिपी इज दीज डिलीशियस एंड सुपर सॉफ्ट स्पॉन्जी इडलीज एज यू हैव सीन हियर बाय द टेक्सचर। टू मेक द स्पॉन्जी एंड सुपर सॉफ्ट इडली वॉच द वीडियो टिल द एंड। टू मेक द राइस इडली हियर आई हैव टेकन 2 cups ऑफ राइस रवा और इडली राइस एज यू हैव सीन बाय द टेक्सचर्स। दिस इज स्लाइटली ग्रेनी एंड इट इज़ ऑल्सो नोन एज क्रीम ऑफ राइस। So here I have taken 1 cup of urad dal or urad dantel soaked 3-4 hours or overnight. I have set this cup to measure the idli rava and the urad dal dantel. You can take any cup and measure accordingly. So when you are about to mix or grind this dantel, just wash the idli rava. Now grind the urad dal into a coarse paste. And this is how it looks like after grinding, slightly grainy. We are looking for this type of consistency. Remove the urad dal paste into the separate bowl. Now you have seen the texture, it's perfect for the idli. Now add the washed idli rice or idli rava in this urad dal mixture or paste and add 1 cup of water and mix everything. If you feel, you can add little more water, and we are looking for this type of consistency as you have seen here. After that, cover the lid and set it aside for about 3-4 hours in a warm place for the fermentation, and then I will show you. Now it's been 3 hours. I have removed it on the countertop and you have seen it's perfectly fermented, and I will show you the closure view. Wow, it's perfectly fermented. The fermentation, depending upon the temperature of your area, it will take little bit more time. Now I'm going to take 4 tablespoons of this mixture in a separate bowl, and I'm going to cover and keep it in the refrigerator for the later use. Now this is the mixture. It is slightly thick, so I'm going to add approximately 1/2 cup of water and make it into a paste. As you have seen here, we are looking for this type of consistency, and add 1 teaspoon of salt or according to your taste, and slightly mix the salt into the batter. Now grease the idli molds or the idli tray with the help of oil, and on the other hand I have kept the cooker and I have add little water so that it will be ready by the time we are greasing the trays. And you have seen on the other hand the water is boiling, and now fill the idli mixture into the idli trays as I'm showing you here. Similar way, fill all the idli trays with the mixture, and after filling all the mixture, here I have set it on the countertop. Now open the lid of the idli cooker and the water is perfect boiled. Now start placing the trays one by one inside the idli cooker. You can use the regular cooker with the same type of trays to steam the idlis. Now cover the lid and on the low medium flame cook the idlis for 10 to 20 minutes, and then I will show you. After 20 minutes, as you have seen here, open the lid and it smells so good, and this is perfectly done. And take one skewer or knife to check whether it is done or not, and if it is come out clean, that means the idlis are perfectly ready. And now wait for about couple of minutes and remove the tray. It is still hot, and with the help of knife or any spoon, remove the idlis, and you have seen it is come out perfectly. That means the idlis are properly steamed. And this is the second one. Similar way, remove all the idlis from the tray. Now I will show you the texture of these idlis, super soft and spongy, as you have seen by the texture also. And in front of you, I will break one idli and show you how it looks like from inside. Perfectly soft and spongy. You can make it easily at home. Serve these rice idlis with coconut chutney or coconut sauce. You can serve hot with different type of chutneys or sambar. You can make it ahead of time and you can fry these also. Make sure when you are making these rice rava idlis, put the batter for the fermentation. If the fermentation is good, then you will get the perfect idli. And if you like this recipe of rice rava idli, then don't forget to like, comment, share and subscribe. Thank you. Thanks for watching.